Hello there, Ali here from Sports Templates, and today I'm bringing you guys this tracksuit template. It's been requested for a while and finally finished working on it. So for this template, we have two views. We have the front view and we have the back view. Each view has the jacket and the pants separate. So if you just want the jacket, you can just turn off the pants and then you have the jacket on its own. If you just want the pants, then turn off the jackets, turn on the pants. You just need to disable this layer mask and remove these two layers, and there you have it. The same thing goes for the back view, or turning on, disabling the layer mask and disabling these shadow layers, and you're good to go. So going back, I found this image of this Adidas tracksuit and I thought it would be fun to recreate it using our template. So I made this little library, kind of picked the colors from here and picked the Adidas original logo. That's gonna come in handy later. I'm gonna start with the jacket. So let's go into editable parts. When you see a layer with the red color here, it means that you can double click on a thumbnail and you can change its color. When it has this purple color, it means that you double click on it and a smart object shows up. So let's start with the torso, but before we do that, let's take a look at where the lines end here. What I'm gonna focus on is this white line where it ends. It ends where the sleeve meets the torso, so I think it's, if we zoom in, it's gonna meet around this area. This is where we can use the grid for our advantage, so we can just count how many squares there's from here to the top. So for example, if we count here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and maybe the seventh square is not visible, so 7 squares up from this your logo graphic. So if you double click on torso and we do the same thing, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so we should stop here, and let's add our shape here. Let's hide the grid and let's color it white, or let's just use the white from our library here. Background color is this, and we also have this rectangle in blue, so we need to add it as well. Let's just duplicate this layer and drag it down and pick the blue color. Then let's remove these placeholder logos. Add the Adidas logo. I've already included guides to help us position logos in the right place. So something around this. Let's copy this color and double click here. Color overlay, the blend mode, and that's about it for the torso. We just need to save. Looks about right. One thing that I just noticed is the stitches. If you want, you can keep them or you can change the color to white. If you want them to blend in, you can just remove this layer and they just get colored, whatever color is covering that area. One more thing is we can just change the zipper color and the base. So the zipper color, we pick the same dark blue. Same thing for the zipper. I'm using this blue color, zipper top, same thing. Interior and collar, so they all have this dark blue color. And now moving on to the sleeves. So in the sleeves layer, you have two options. You have, if you hide the grid, you have three stripes for Adidas designs, or you have this anthem pattern for Nike designs. So if you turn on three stripes and you change the color to this dark blue and the three stripes to this lighter blue, save it. That's about it. One more thing is we need to extend this white to the sleeve. So coming back, basically we just need to eyeball it and then test and see if we need to make it bigger or smaller. So I think something around this, make it white, and let's save and see. All right, we need to make it a little bit longer. So Control T and drag, Control S to save. coming back. All right, seems like it lines up. I think this edge needs to be a little bit down. So what we can do is we can just move this corner individually. So what I did is use the direct selection tool and I just selected this corner, and now I'm gonna drag it down a little bit, something like this. Maybe drag this one up just a tad bit and Control S, save. Seems about right. Next, we can just copy the same design to the right sleeve. So if you open it up, double click, coming back here, open this one up, and basically just remove the grid, use the same colors, turn on the three stripes, change its color. What we need to copy from here is just the white part. So shift, select, and drag, and put it behind three stripes. What we need to do here is just Control T, right click, and flip horizontal so it goes the other way. Control S and save, and there we have it. I just noticed that we need to make the collar white as well. So coming back here, select the collar, make it white, as well as the interior. We're almost done with the jacket. What's left is the bottom of the jacket. Also, one more thing is we can change these colors to blue also. These, the base colors for the sleeves. So blue for here and the bottom blue as well, as well as the back. That's gonna be visible when you turn off the pants. Let's also make the cuffs this dark blue. And now we're done with the jacket. We can move on to working on the pants and the shoes. We go to editable parts, and let's start with the left leg design. Hide the grid, make the base color this navy blue, turn on three stripes, make it blue, and save. And you can see here it applies to the left leg. Now doing the right leg, same thing, hide grid, change color, turn on the stripes, and save. Now moving on to the shoes. I want to make the base this dark color, and then the body is white, maybe the laces, keep them white, and this band thing, maybe do it blue. Or you know what, we can do the base also this navy blue, gonna keep it in line. One more thing is, there's this pants top that's not visible now because of the jacket. We can also use this blue, or maybe like a lighter blue, and we're pretty much done with the front view. One last thing I would do is just change the background color. So maybe something like this, kind of add contrast to the design. We can zoom in to check out the details. This is a 7K template, so you're getting all high level details. And if you want, you can see how things look if you hide parts of the design. So if you want to hide the pants and the shoes, we can just have the jacket on its own. So we can add it to any other design, or we can turn on the pants and just disable this layer mask and hide these two layers, and we have it on its own separate layer. The same steps apply for the back. So I'm just gonna fast forward while I do this part, but that's about it for this template. Pretty simple, pretty easy to edit, super high quality. Keep an eye on Sports Templates for more stuff to come. We're releasing new templates every month. Lots of cool stuff coming up for football season, basketball season, rugby, and a bunch of other stuff. See you guys on the next one. We'll be right back.
the moon.